as we can see during the we will see during the day. So again, on the relevance of the study, they constitute an heterogeneous group now. They within the public opinion, professional self-employed were in the past associated with innovation, economic development, and prosperity, and they are assimilated to the upper middle class and winners, in a sense, in the new liberal era. Nowadays, this that was an idealized picture of the independent professionals or self-employed professional, describes them as high earners, high consumers, able to protect their incomes and including insurance and pension and professional upgrading and mobility. So this idealized image of these middle class of workers are nowadays very has been in discussion, put in discussion. So reinforced by the financial crisis, especially in Europe, specific difficulties and accumulated difficulties affecting the middle class, whose professional self-employed are an essential component, emerged. So the crisis showed all the difficulties and the problems more and more linked to the medium and low level income of these workers. So there is a sort of impoverishment, a process of impoverishment of these professionals. So the crisis stimulated the demand of knowledge workers, independent workers, for greater social and professional protection. Not only social, but also professional, because there are some weak aspects of the professionalities and the conservation of the skills and update their skills and their competence, etc. For some forms of self-help, for associations and collective representation across Europe. So, during the crisis, the difficulties of these groups of workers are emerging more clearly. So, and their need, their social need and professional needs appeared with more evidence. In fact, the proliferation of professional services showed a lack of benefits typically associated with traditional working sectors and occupation. What we mean with this lack of traditional benefits? Unemployment benefits and sickness, maternity, paternity, accidents at work, old age, disability, but also something related to the career, because the outsider careers, not within the firm, within the boundaries of firms, are more at risk. For example, in terms of training, in terms of incentives for self-employment, etc., in terms of fiscal condition and taxation, that is very crucial for these workers. Thus, the necessity for an adaptation, an adequation, and extension of the social safety net for these workers. So, within this preliminary framework, the iWire project had a twofold objective. One is to pinpoint the socioeconomic needs and demands raised by the across the European labor market in the European labor markets associated with their legal status and working condition. This is the one of the tasks of the project. The second one was analyzing the responses to these needs coming from institutions and traditional and non-traditional collective representation, how the scenario of the organization means unions, casa unions and labor market intermediaries are able to do something for these new needs of this category of workers, or some other example of community-based association. And we will see in the next presentation that there is a very dynamic scenario in this perspective. So we adopted a comparative perspective to study these topics, and there are represented Belgium, France, nine European countries, Belgium, France, Germany, Italy, Netherlands, Slovenia, Spain, Sweden, and the United Kingdom. So the comparative analysis in Europe, here is the map with all the participants that are not only universities, not only a partnership of academic, but also other kind of associations. So we adopted a multidimensional analysis across three levels. We consider a macro institutional level, focusing on the national regulatory framework, a meso organizational level, considering the representative organization, and through case studies, and the micro individual level through a survey. So the research outcomes are very rich. We have 9 national reports, 30 case studies of organization, and an important international survey. So I try to summarize our approach in this table, and where we consider from one side the three level, macro, meso, and micro, and the first one is the theoretical orientation. So at the macro level we use institutional analysis, at the meso level we use organizational analysis, and the micro level you use, of course, subject orientation at individual level. The unit of analysis are countries at the macro level, are organization and association or representation at the meso level, and individuals at the micro level. The empirical focus is self-employment regulation in the European member states for the micro level, the structure and offer of collective representation for the meso level, and the independent professional working condition for the micro level. So the methodological approach has been a comparative, a cross-country analysis for the first level, and national case studies on organization and selection of good practices for the intermediate level, and the survey through workers at the micro level. Which are the main challenges? The main challenges, the focus of the project is the collective action problems facing a fragmentation of labor market, an extremely fragmentation of the labor market. So the main challenge is how the organization and the association of interest are able to represent some disaggregation of workers at the global and local level too. So at the macro level, the challenge is if it's possible to arrive to a European common framework, for example, for a common legal status, the recognition of a similar status all over the Europe. Because one of the main problems we had in starting with the research was between the countries, between partners. So we devoted a lot of time to understand each other on which were the population that we studied, which are independent, both self-employed, etc., etc. So the legal status is one of the main problematic topic since the beginning of the project. So it could be very useful, a sort of a new classification or a new adaptation of the legal status in respect to these workers. And this is the challenge at the macro level. At the meso level, how we can support the coordination through coalition building, reframe of employment relation system for these workers, and at the micro level, how to improve the working condition through supportive networks for professional improvement and personal development. So the starting after a lot of discussion within the partners on who was the subject, we agree with the starting definition adopted for independent professional by Rappelli. The report was European IPROS, a study professional contractors group in 2012. And the condition are, the starting definition are that we want to consider self-employed without employees. It was the first condition. The second was a person engaged in economic activity which does not belong to the farming, craft and retail sector. And we have here the list of the sector that we consider. The NACE, I don't know how to say, categories. And the third condition is that they have to be engaged in activities of an intellectual nature and or which come under service sector. So technical and intellectual skills and competencies. What we know about these independent professionals, what we know about the IPROS. The first European study estimated the number of freelancers professionals amounting around 8,500,700 persons, with a rate growth of 82% in the last 10 years. While other categories of both self-employed and employees are stable or decreasing. Next presentation will enter much more in the detail. But we know that this is the only category of workers that is increased. And we update this trend on 2015, and we estimate that the trend was growing again, especially in Italy, in UK, in Germany, and France. And here we have, we can say that the red line, yes, you can see, is the iCross, as we have defined them before, is the only category that is growing up. And we update the trend, and the blue one is iCross, independent professional, and we confirm this trend. They are mainly concentrated in professional activities, but the next presentation will be more detailed in that. I skip all the... And what the statistical data say? Say, for example, four things. That the relevant growth of professional self-employed involved in the relevant growth of this figure. The second is that it is a structural, nor a contingent trend. Only a small part is bonus self-employment, similar to employee working for one main client, but the majority are real self-employed, working for numerous clients. So a lot of the debate, for example, in Italy has been trapped in the are they really self-employed or bogus self-employed? I'm finishing. And now we are going on in demonstrating that the majority of these workers are really self-employed. A minority are bogus self-employed. And it represents an increasing occupational form. strategic to the contemporary capitalistic model, which need more flexibility, high-skill-based competencies, and multitasking, the concept of growth professional. So we highlighted three main critical dimensions. One is the institutional recognition of the status, as I said before, because we have a confused legal status of these kind of workers, a strong deficit of social protection, a strong fragmentation in the system of social protection, and a lack of social protection for these workers, and the challenges of their collective representation. So the project has been developed on these three main topics, problematic topics regarding these groups of workers. Which are the research question? Given these three critical dimensions, is there a process of convergent responses in Europe in terms of legal clarity on the different forms of self-employment, in terms of welfare and economic solution to their social and professional needs? So the question is, there is convergence, or each country are going on with their own specificity? The second is, are there innovative regulation laws, policies and practices at country or regional level able to respond to these institutional critical dimensions? Is there room for innovative strategies from the social partners? And the last, are these new configurations of collective representation able to transform the traditional practices in employment relation, and how? And could we predict, in a sense, a new era of collective representation and the rise of a new durable solidarities? These are some of the main questions that we want to respond to. From my point of view, and this is I'm finishing, there is a sort of big contradiction in this capitalist model that exploits, in a sense, these workers that are very strategic, from very high skilled and very strategic for the economy. But the paradox is that they do not give to them something in exchange. As the previous model, the Fordist model, they exploited the workers, but there was a counterpart in the sense that the Fordist model of capitalism incentives workers, and they pay a lot of workers and ensure their position, even if, of course, the Fordist enterprises create alienation, etc., etc. But the paradox of this model of capitalism is that they need these kind of workers, high-skilled, very specific skills, but there is really a lack in the sense of wage level, especially, and social protection. They give a lot of autonomy, but there is a strong lack in terms of social security and income security. Okay. Thank you very much. Now I present... Thank you. So I present Cristina Zanni. She's a co-founder and researcher of ACTA, that is one of the main partners of this project, and she will speak about the needs and socioeconomic condition of freelancers, the result of the empirical survey that we conducted in the project.